Hello, this is Rich, and we are going to demonstrate how to do the universal release method. Okay? First we're going to fix our hair because we want to look good on camera. So, that's a want. I'm wanting to look good on camera. And this, we can use this as a demonstration because it's something I really want. Look at me trimming myself on the camera, right? And so there's emotional energy connected with that. See, I normally wouldn't express that feeling. Or that desire, that want. So the release questions, they're called universal because this list of questions, excuse me, that you can't see, and nobody can ever see anything that anybody shoves in front of the camera. See, that's freaking ridiculous. But if you want to try the method, send me a mail, a private message, and I'll send you the questions. Now, the way you do the process, well, first of all, yeah, where do we start? So I want to look good on camera. I want to explain these things. I have little emotional things. And we can use all these different things to plug in to the release method. The list of questions have a blank. And in that blank, you plug in your item. And your item is what you call the thing that you want to release. Now, it works best if your item has the ing word coming first. You know, your item will usually be a phrase. Feeling resentment, feeling insecure, believing my girlfriend doesn't love me. You see how the phrase, the first word has an ing word in it? Wanting to quit my job. Now, all these things. And I'm wanting to look good on camera, and I'm seeing this. There's this shiny thing. So now I'm all fussing with the camera. The reason I'm talking about this is because the things we want cause us to do things, and the things we want, if fulfilled, will make us feel better. So there's a strong relationship between what we want, what we feel, and what we believe. So these are the three key things that we can do release work on because they work so well together. That said, you pick your item and you use a word processor. If you want to plug the item into your, if you got the word, the part of wanting to look good on camera, right, is talking to yourself and explaining it properly. Okay, so plug in your item into the questions and go. Now you can do it audio. You can read the questions like this. You can type your answers to each question. You can talk to somebody else as you ask yourself your questions. It's always a good idea to write your item on a post-it. This is a post-it. So I'm going to write down wanting to look good on camera. You know how everybody's got some key issues? I apparently have one called vanity. Because here I am. I'm often talking about this subject. So I've written my item on this piece of paper. And so here's my questions with the blanks. Let's try that. There it is. Even at Christmas. Yeah. So these are the questions. This is in mirror image, but there they are. So you can just kind of put your post-it down here somewhere if you want. This is all ridiculously too detailed. But so you get your questions, and you have your item. And you plug in your item as you ask the question. Let's see. Give me a sec here while I try to look good on camera, and we will be asking the first question. So right now I'm tweaking the lighting. So a question. Now normally I start with the top question first, and after the first four or five questions, you can mix them up and ask any question you want. But generally, the way I've organized the questions is that it kind of flows kind of nice if you just do one question right after the other. Okay? Now, it doesn't matter, there's no right way to answer the question or wrong way. Just the question will inspire you to respond. And the idea is that you respond verbally, because this is one of the better ways to express your feelings. And the questions get you to talk about things that will help you express your feelings, and the questions also help you look at things you never normally look at regarding the thing that you want to release. Now, another thing about releasing your stuff, it has to do with the idea that we are hanging on to our stuff for a reason. It's a subconscious reason, but we won't let it go for its survival value. So if we can spot the reasons we're hanging on to our stuff and bring it to the surface, it stops being a subconscious choice to hang on, and we go, oh, wait, that's not a good reason. I don't like that. I'm going to let go. See, you can view it, but if you can't see why you're hanging on to it, you can't work around that deep-seated logic, subconscious logic, as it were. It's actually a computation, it's not logic. So, all that done, as you answer these questions, your item will release. In other words, you will stop wanting it and move into getting it, or you will stop wanting it because it's not worth wanting or getting either one. So there's different ways it will go if you release something that you're wanting. Like if you're wanting a donut and you're not getting a donut, and you're really releasing it because you want to get rid of the desire to have it, you can release wanting the donut so you don't want it anymore, which is a good thing. So that's that. You answer questions about something that you believe. You believe it, you don't like believing it. Let's say you believe that bad things are going to happen within the next couple of years. So the item would be, believing bad things are going to happen in the next couple of years. Big long item. And so you would plug in that item into each of these blanks in your questions list. Making sense? That's all the jazz about it. Now let's actually do it. So this is a relatively light, it's not seriously emotionally charged item, wanting to look good on camera. But it is something I'm interested in talking about and releasing. And the reason I want to release it, this item, is because I don't want to be worried about looking good on camera. I don't want to look on camera. You look good on camera. I just want to, like, hey, can I just turn the camera on and do my thing and stop fussing about it? So that's why I would want to release this item. So it's got to be something you want to release. You got to be able to get in touch with it too. You don't want to release anger, feeling angry, for example, if you're not feeling angry. Let's say you got angry at your lover, if you got one, if you're lucky enough to have one of those. Okay, so you're angry at your lover, and you had a little falling out, and you're pissed off, and you want to release the anger. But that was yesterday you were angry. Right now you're not angry. Now, it might be suppressed anger. It's anger, but you can't get in touch with it. Some people can't get in touch with their anger very well. I can, but some people can't. So you want to release the anger, but it's not there to release. It's like it's suppressed. So you might instead word your item suppressing your anger. So then you got the ing word is the first word, and you can actually get in touch with right now, in the moment, while you do the release work, you can get in touch with suppressing your anger. See, so that's how it works. Okay, with no further ado, I'm going to start with the first question. And this is just how it's done. What might be some of your reasons for, you can read it right off your post-it, wanting to look good on camera? Richard, are you there? And I just do this back and forth thing just for fun. You don't have to do it this way. It's good to record your items, record your session. So the question is, Rich, what might be some of the reasons for wanting to look good on camera? Well, I want to look good on camera. Because I don't like looking bad on camera. It's I have issues. Yeah, I get on myself about how I look on camera. I go, I don't look good. And so I'm insulting myself. I'm making less of myself. And this is all ridiculous. And, I shouldn't be doing that. And right now I see my hair is all fucked up. And so you're starting to see I really have some agitation, real energy and emotion on this. And it's actually kind of uncomfortable talking about it on camera. Because a lot of what I say is how I look, how I'm coming across on camera. And basically, that's part of the stuff. So another question is, what does wanting to look good? Oh, you asked. I'm sorry, you asked me this. We're getting frantic and crazy because we're running out of time. And we wanted to do this all in one 15-minute segment here. Next question. Okay, so he responded emotionally, verbally, expressed himself in response to the first question. It doesn't matter what he said. Okay, now. You pick the next question, and if you don't like the next question, just skip it. But here's the next question. Is wanting to look good on camera new to you? No, it's not new to me. No, I used to have really big issues on looking on camera. See, this looks crappy. I just don't like what that looks like, that whole front looks. But the side look looks pretty good, especially if the lighting's good. Okay, well, thank you. Now, we're going to wrap it up here only because we're running out of time on the video. But he got a little bit of an emotional release, and some chuckles and laughs came off. But we're not, normally we wouldn't be done here because, we got gazillions of more questions that we could ask and answer. But I hope this gives a quick demo. And we can pick it up in another video here. We just might do that. But this is a quickie on how the process works with the explanations. So if your item is feeling not confident, just write that on a piece of paper and plug it into these questions. Ask the question and then answer it. Or put it on paper or on your word processor. Globally replace all of the blanks with your item. Feeling not confident, and then just type your answers. It works better if you can do it verbally. And you can even cut a video if you want and upload the video, make it private on YouTube. Nobody else can see it. Give me the link. I'll watch your video, and it'll be like me giving you a release session using the very same questions that I would ask you or I would even ask myself. So, okay, I hope we got this under 15 minutes. Ah! Okay, talk to you later. Hey, thanks for doing this, Rich. Bye now.